you generate a ton of inbound leads from social media, from Facebook, mm-hmm. organically. Organic. Like referrals friggin' galore. Mm-hmm. You are the king.
Okay. Thank you. I appreciate that.
You are the king.
Thank you. Okay?
Talk about that. Get your freaking pad out.
Yeah, I'm gonna give y'all just straight tips and tricks. You can also, I have a full recording on my organic social media strategies on ATX Agent Hangout. It's my networking page.
On the Facebook page?
On Facebook page, ATX Agent Hangout.
Boom.
Specific for Texas agents. Honestly, Cody is who inspired me to start it.
Thanks,
bro. Because events, there's just power behind events. I want people to be in the room. I don't care if it's 10 or 1. Like, I really don't care as long as I'm impacting at least one person. That's right. And that's hard to do virtually. So,
Personally, real quick, yeah. Okay, stay tuned. But real quick, how much have you personally changed since you started attending events the last, really, really heavy, the last 6-8 months?
Tenfold, man.
Okay, tenfold. Boom. Okay, back to organic.
It really is crazy.
It's nuts.
Yeah, so to start with, you have to have social media. So yes. I always start with that. Check. And I'm like, especially if you don't like being on it, I don't care.
Yeah.
Like, then you don't like making money. Because you need to be on social media. You really need to. So I don't care if you want to do it. Some people do it on Instagram. Some people do it on Facebook, Twitter.
Yep.
Brandon Thomas, he actually is buying stuff from you. He's a king on Twitter. I don't do Twitter.
Whoa.
I'm Facebook. But he is like the life guy on Twitter, which is awesome. If you can leverage, even if you're just leveraging one of those platforms.
I noticed that most people go really deep in one platform.
Yes.
Because it's hard to be everything mm-hmm. to everyone and be great at all of them. Like yours is Facebook.
Yep.
Mine has always been YouTube. Clearly, we're doing it right now.
Yep.
So let's keep talking about Facebook because you're freaking great at that.
Yeah, so Facebook is my go-to. I don't think I would be able to get onto another platform because my wife would probably kill me.
You're already on that one
yeah,
a lot.
Yeah, and really Facebook, which leads into really how I've been able to generate all of this stuff, is groups.
Yep.
The other platforms don't really have groups like Facebook does.
Not as well. What about LinkedIn groups? Not yet, really?
I'm just now kind of tapping into LinkedIn. Okay. I'm using LinkedIn more as recruiting versus actually...
Because those LinkedIn groups can get huge, but mm-hmm. I don't think they're as active as the Facebook groups.
Exactly.
Facebook every day.
Yeah.
I'm not on LinkedIn every day.
Exactly. I hop on LinkedIn to check my notifications in the morning, and that's pretty... I'll put some stuff out there, but I don't...
Cool.
Facebook is where I live. So really, it starts with you gotta have Facebook, right? If you want to be on Facebook, you gotta have one. And then creating your audience. So you need to... If you're going to use Facebook as a business tool, which if you're not using it as a business tool, then don't do it. If it's not driving revenue.
There's not points to you. I wouldn't use it. I wouldn't use it at all.
And people are like, dude, how do you have time to do all this? And I was like, because it makes me money.
You make time. Yeah. Like, you guys will make time for whatever makes you mm-hmm. successful. Whatever. Yep. If it helps your business and you really want to do something, you will find time. That's what I've learned.
It's funny because people ask, they say, oh, dude, how do you have all this time to be so quick on commenting? And I'm like, because Facebook's like my second CRM.
Yeah.
Here's my CRM. Here's Facebook. And then like, here's my carrier systems. Facebook never comes down. And you have to manipulate the algorithm. So when you're building your audience, when you're adding people and you're joining groups. So first kind of define your audience. Okay. Who is going to actually make you money, right? So for PNC, I'm getting in. One of my groups is new to Austin, 20s and 30s. It's people who are moving to Austin. I can be their relocation expert, right? Obviously trucking. So I got in with a trucking group. There's 33,000 members in there. Obviously, that's a good group for me if I'm in trucking, right?
That's freaking great.
Real estate investors. So it's another thing. I don't do the like hotels, motels. I have a referral partner for that. But any like apartment complexes, things like that, I can do that all day.
Wow.
So joining groups that I can leverage.
So you've found what pieces of your audience you want to niche down in and who you want to work with. Mm-hmm. And clearly, like trucking and apartment buildings and stuff, that's not a renter's policy.
It's not. And I will say, actually, before you go do that, go to your carriers first. A lot of people are saying, I'm for the client. No, the client doesn't pay you. The company does.
Yeah.
Right? So you need to go to your carrier and say, what do you want?
That's good.
What do you give
certain carriers certain types of business based on what they want?
100%.
That's freaking smart. I've never thought about that in the PNC world.
So like all my auto body shops. So I'm really the reason I do auto body shops is because I'm accelerated through underwriting. I can have same day binding through Nationwide. If they're not with Nationwide, I win every single time.
Wow.
And if they are with Nationwide, I just do an agent of record change, and then I get the commissions at renewal, and I can be their servicing agent.
So how many inbound social leads do you think you get a month? I know it's
I'd have to go check my CRM.
I know it's over a certain number for sure. I just don't know what it is
with my commercial, with all my trucking and my just referrals from people, obviously me posting and engaging and gaining leads, I like probably 120
a month.
I quote probably close to $2 million in trucking insurance every month. Yeah.
Close to $2 million trucking a month, just you're
trucking.
Quoting.
Yeah. Now, granted, that's extremely high for anybody who knows trucking. Which, don't start in trucking. Get your feet wet with the personal lines, and then when you're ready for trucking, you can
Now you guys see, I was like, this is the cat.
Yeah.
Dang. Okay, so what's some other tips on like leveraging social organically other than groups? Like maybe like one, leave us with like one small tip on like, you have a Facebook. You defined your audience.
Yep.
You found some groups you want to be in.
Mm-hmm.
How do you, what's the next step? What's a tip?
Add those people in the groups. So the people that are, even like people who are referring you business, or you're now going in and you're kind of that insurance person in that group, whatever it is. And actually before we get there, don't solicit right out the gate. So you want to lead with value and education.
You would think that's a no-brainer. Most people are spamming the crap out of groups. It's all bad.
Or they'll just go straight to the DMs without, I'm like, why should I even talk with you? You haven't even helped me.
Exactly.
This is Coach Burt. You know, people do business when problems are solved.
That's right.
And so help them solve the problem.
Yep.
I don't even ask to be their agent. I will literally say, hey, this is what you need. This, 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 and this.
That's freaking cool.
And then they message me.
So, like, so hey, you'll bring value in the group.
Correct.
Then you will go and actually add those individuals that are engaging. Mm-hmm. You probably even go to their actual personal post and start engaging. Why? Because you're helping the relationship.
We are humans.
Yeah.
They don't know that unless they're on my page, which I think a lot of people are like, I don't want those people following me. And it's like, well, then you're not using Facebook as a business tool.
Yeah.
And all you want, you just want your friends and your family. And the next thing you know, you're looking at a bunch of pictures of babies or your friend just got married. And then, oh, what do you know? Now you're on YouTube. And you're down the rabbit hole.
That's right.
I want my referral partners seeing what I'm doing with my family.
That's strong.
I want them to see that I'm human. Just because I sell insurance doesn't mean I'm not. Like, I have the same bills. I've got a kid. You know, like, we have all these things that they can all relate to if they see it.
Yes.
So add them. Add them. And that also builds your audience. And then what do you know? Who do they know?
Right.
Normally people that are in the same like kind or, you know, similar situation that they are, whether it's the same occupation or same income, whatever it is, you know, people who are at income levels normally hang out with either 10 below or above in the same income.
That's awesome.
So Adam, and then I would say really, I'd say that the last bit is you've just got to engage consistently. I think a lot of people, that's where they give up on Facebook. They'll post something. This is a huge one. They'll post something. Nobody likes it. It's like, well, just because they didn't like it doesn't mean they didn't see it. You just weren't there to solve their problem yet.
Yeah.
So that's why you have to keep posting.
People, they'll get depressed and stop posting.
Yes. They will stop because nobody likes it. And I'm like, no, they just don't need you right now.
Yeah.
But the day that every single day, if you're posting that every single day, life changes.
Does that also teach you over time what types of stuff to post based on the engagement you get? You know now, okay.
So I'll give you guys the jab, jab, hook. Okay, so we call it the jab, jab, and then you're coming around with the hook. Basically, that's your business post. So the jab is,
you jab a lot more than twice, by the way.
I do. This is where you need to start, though. Because it can be overwhelming.
Yeah.
To have to post 10 to,
that's true.
I mean, I'm probably, you rub in my comments, posts, and everything, I'm probably, it's over 50 a day,
that's
easily.
Awesome. That's huge.
So yeah, but do the two jabs, right? So you can call them jabs or fluff. Basically get them, put something out there to where they want to respond, right? We have to view social media like Facebook is for entertainment. Social media as a whole is people want to be entertained, okay? They ultimately do.
That's good.
And when you entertain them, Facebook ranks you higher. We don't have time for the algorithm stuff, but we'll do another one on that maybe someday. But just give them like, hey, if you had to remove one, so tacos, brisket, ribs, or, you know, whatever. It's so funny. Like, and it only needs to be one little, they could just put, you know, ribs or brisket or tacos. That's it. I don't need anything else.
Yep.
They can't resist not to.
What is that?
It's so, I don't know. It's a fluff. It's like, it's that engagement post.
Somebody told me to start with like, just curious, ..
Yep.
And then do that with like a question. And it always works.
Mine's in the comments. So then you kick it off and then people are like, oh, there's already a comment.
Oh, let me see what Joe likes.
Yep. And there's like, oh, okay. So
what are the three options again?
Like ribs, tacos, brisket, You could do any of the food items, like, hey, remove one. Or if you could, if you had to live without one, what would it be? And people are like,
people love that stuff, especially food, man. I don't know what it is, but
it is so funny. And so they'll post, and then this is a huge part of the organic strategy.
Yeah.
Because Facebook likes when you keep people on their platform, right? That's right. How I get ranked higher. That's how I hit more timelines. That's how I get in
that's
front
exactly
of more people.
That's exactly why we don't post links straight to YouTube on Facebook, because they don't want people to leave. They're not going to promote that.
They don't. They don't. Yeah. You want them. So then when they comment, even if it's just ribs, I will go in and say, if I agree, oh, dude, right on, man. I knew I liked you. Or if I didn't, then I'd be like, are you crazy, dude? Like, what are you talking about? And then they're going to comment again. And then guess what's happening? I'm keeping them on the platform.
That's smart.
So Facebook loves me. And a lot of people will allow, you'll have like 100, even if you have 100 comments, right?
Yeah.
You're like, oh, 100 comments. If you were to comment on every single one of those comments, you'd have 200 comments.
Exactly.
So Facebook looks at that and it's like, ooh, organic. Like, man, people are all over this post, and whoever's posting it is engaging them, keeping them on my platform.
Zuckerberg's like, Joe Camper is a
like,
freak,
oh, dude,
bro.
Put him up here. Relevancy, right? He's the most relevant. People must like this dude.
Yeah.
So I'll do two of those, right, to get people really engaged. And the second one I'll do maybe more of a sentimental, like maybe a picture of my daughter, me hanging out with my family, showing I'm human, right? But then a lot of people are attracted to that. And then you hit them with the business post. So that's when you'll get, you'll go from like, I remember when I first got married, it was like 700. So I was like, man, where have all y'all been, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And then I'll post, but it was kind of bad because I used that because I knew people were on my page because they've been liking all my posts from that weekend. Posted a business post, only got 15 likes or something. And I'm like, dang. But I know that all of those people that have been liking my page all weekend, they saw it. They just didn't need me yet.
That's right.
And that's why you do it on a daily basis,
that's
because
right.
one day they will need you.
Wow.
And you're already there. You're in front of them, and they've seen so much of your stuff that when they need you, ah, Joe, dude, I thought I need help with my insurance, man. You are the first person I thought of. They didn't really think of me. I just plugged it into their head because I'm in front of them all the time.
The first people I think about with insurance all the time.
Yep.
You know?
That's because I'm freaking posting everywhere.
An animal.
Yeah.
How to be an insurance animal.
And then I'll give just
okay,
this
last
is the last bit. When you're posting is huge.
Yeah.
So you need to be posting at what Facebook calls primetime hours. What I've found has been the most engagement, when people are most willing to respond or engage or comment or like or whatever. You need to be posting anywhere from like 7 to 8 a.m. Okay. And then also gauge your audience. So if your audience is all on the East Coast and you're in Central, then you need to be posting earlier to get them before they get too busy into their day.
There you go.
Okay. So anywhere from 7 to 8 a.m. And then anywhere from 11 to 12. So you're catching people on their lunch breaks. When they have their phones out, right? They've got some time in between the day. They're scrolling through their timelines, right? And then really anything from like 4:30, 4:45, don't post too early. Some people will put it out there at 4.
Mm.
People are still finishing up their work day.
Yep.
Get them right at like 4:30, 4:45.
So you're almost like right before.
Right before 5.
I love that.
And then boom. And then that's your prime time hours.
Yep. How do they follow you? Because they want to keep following you after
you
this.
Can find me, Joe Frazier Camper. So I'm very active on my personal page.
Yep.
We are Redwood Agency Group for the business page. And then also I've got ATX Agent Hangout, which is my networking page. A lot of good value on that.
And
this is my baby right now, the Insurance Syndicate. Basically, we are trying to disrupt the industry through honesty and transparency of information. So
that's the Facebook group.
That is the Facebook group. So come join us. If you're trying to join the group, please fill out the three questions. All you have to do is hit yes, yes, yes. If you don't, I'm deleting you, because that already is telling me that you're not trying to level up. You can't even answer the questions. Like, come on, y'all.
You've been deleted, okay?
Yes, you're out.
All right.
Sorry. Try again.
Thank you, bro.
Yeah.
Okay? You're
thank
a beast.
You.
Follow this man.
Yes, sir. Thank you, man.
Hey, if you enjoyed this, I got another one you're going to love. It's right there. Click on it. See you in there.
Believe you're going to be at the top. No matter if you are in ops, if you're in sales, if you are the janitor right now,
that's right.
Be the best janitor you can be. You know,